Hello everyone, I'm Anime Freak and welcome to my video. Today I am going to be reacting to Team 4 Stars Dragon Ball Z The History of Trunks. Now if you haven't seen this video, make sure you go in the description box below. There's a link there to Team 4 Stars History of Trunks. So as soon as you've watched that, come back, watch me watch this. And if you guys want to see the other reactions I've done with the Dragon Ball Z Abridged series that Team Four Stars done, then it's on my channel. It's on my playlists. If you want to go and check them out, please do. And so yeah, with that said, let's get watching. Yeah. This is gonna be fun. Okay. All right, you guys ready? Okay. 3, 2, 1, and go. A moment of silence to the maker of Ruby.
Hello, my name is Trunks.
Hello, Trunks.
And this is my story.
Is it?
I mean, I was a baby during this part, so the details are a little unclear.
Mom, what happened? Your dad is dead! For good!
No!
No!
I'm told those were my first words.
Son of a bitch!
And those were my second.
He just got back from his training. After getting back from his training. After being dead.
And with the death of Goku, his family and friends were left to mourn. For approximately 6 months.
Hey girl, how you look?
Leaving the fate of the Earth with little hope.
I saw the latest episodes of Dragon Ball Super. Come on, I'll go watch the latest episode. That's a good opening to that. Right, here we go.
Over the next 13 years, the androids would destroy small town after small town, working their way up. Maybe that's why we reacted the way we did.
And welcome back, folks, to TJ
and
the Wombat.
Me so horny.
This hour with sports, the College Battle Ball
Association
has had to disband
entirely. There are androids roaming about, and
have been destroyed by the cyborgs.
So,
speaking of which,
yeah.
Cyborg news.
As we currently speak,
yeah. Why is everybody else standing around still for going into their shelters, anyways?
Wombat's getting married.
Poor guy.
My beloved fiance resides in Paprikaburg, and is probably most certainly dying as we speak.
You seem very calm about it. Douchebag.
Silver lining, I'm single again!
Oh, hey! Those guys are funny.
I miss country.
Mom, do you believe in destiny?
I'm a scientist, so no.
Paprikaburg is only 30 miles from here. If I hurry, I could save someone.
Or you could die like your father.
Why do you say that every time I want to go fight them?
Because you are 13, I'm 37, and I am all alone.
My mother had been 37 for 10 years.
No means no. End of discussion. No, just fly away. That's fine. God bless him.
Hey, 18, you keeping score?
Why would I be doing that?
You said you would.
No, you said, hey, check this shit out, then jumped in a car.
Aw, oh, come on, sis. Is
this I like 17.
Shop earlier?
He's cool.
Oh, man, you wouldn't believe this haul. This is why I love these little inner city shops. They always have the best brands. What the hell? Why did you blow it up? They were giving me free clothes.
Didn't give me nothing.
It was a woman's clothing store.
Hey, I'm perfectly secure.
Is that why you dye your hair?
Don't hate.
He's so cool.
I wasn't able to do anything at all, but I had to at least try to stop their chaos. Unfortunately, I was too late.
I like the present to 17 more though.
But as I
symbolism
of that demolished city, a hero appeared.
the hero of my time, Gohan. And face to face with him, all I could say was,
Gohan, thank you, destroy cities and all that is everybody's head.
Sounds like the remainder party of the EU.
You remember a time before this, Gohan? What was it like?
Well, when I was a toddler, my uncle showed up, kidnapped me, and then Mr. Piccolo killed him and my dad. Then Mr. Piccolo kidnapped me, the Saiyans showed up, killed a bunch of people, including Mr. Piccolo. Then we went to Namek, a bunch more people died, we came back, then my dad died again, then all my friends died, and now everyone else is dying.
But it was better, right?
No.
Well, I can help. I'm half Saiyan, just like you.
I've got one, Mr. Piccolo.
What?
I said, from now on, you shall be my pupil. And you will call me Mr. Gohan.
Oh, okay. Would you Mr. like to stay for dinner, Mr. Gohan?
Mr. Gohan would.
Trunks, are you home? Or should I change my dating profile from single mother to just single? Because one gets more hits. Oh, Gohan. Long time no see.
Bulma.
So, Gohan, you staying the night? We got plenty of room here, but, you know, no extra beds, so we'll have to share.
MILF!
I'm good.
Well, worth a shot. Who's hungry? You wouldn't believe how hard it is to get produce nowadays. Luckily, we have our own greenhouses. Don't ask me where I get the protein from, though. Oh, you are just like your father.
In what regard?
Well, you're strong and brave, and look at you in that gi.
It was the only thing he left me.
Aw, that's sweet.
Oh, I see, she's a cradle robber.
For the next few weeks, Gohan would begin training me, focusing on making me a Super Saiyan like him. His methods were dodgy.
Dodge!
Ouch.
Help me, Mr. Gohan!
Fly up!
The whirlpool's too strong! I can't swim!
I said, fly up!
Maybe I can build a raft!
Just shoot him.
Here, clean yourself up.
Yeah, with a small towel.
You think I'm rough, you should have trained with Mr. Piccolo.
You really looked up to him, didn't you?
Yeah, he was like the father I never had.
You know, speaking of dads, Mom never talks about mine. You knew him, right? What was he like?
So what? You think having a dad who's a Super Saiyan makes you better than me?
No!
Wrong answer!
He had a lot to prove.
Gohan would never talk much about his family. Apparently, his mother and grandfather lived alone in the woods.
I'm home, and I've got groceries. How are you doing, sweetheart?
I should be a grandmother, you know.
Oh.
I should be a grandmother with a Nobel Prize winning son. But what am I? A widow. With a son who never talks to me and is possibly dead. So I'm just gonna sit here and knit this baby sweater.
So,
that's creepy.
Is dinner happening?
Will dinner bring my husband back?
Maybe.
Go on.
Actually, that might happen.
Pushing me harder and harder, day and night, to become a Super Saiyan.
That's it. Look at him, Mr. Piccolo. He's almost ready. What do you think?
I think the only real training you'll ever get in this world is on the battlefield.
True.
You're right.
The next day,
he's crazy.
Attack Super World.
Hello and welcome to Super World.
Okay, so
let's hold on. The line.
Okay.
Huh?
What is up with everybody?
You can't cut the line.
Do you not know who we are?
If you'd like to get on the rides faster, we do have a fast pass system that's only 7,900 zen.
This is why I hate theme parks.
Whee!
Yeah, you know, when you can fly, these rides don't really seem that fun.
Well, if you're already bored, why not try taking a ride on my fist?
Wow, you want a minute to rephrase that there, Chief?
Nope,
yeah, I guess.
I'd rather take that minute to kick your ass.
Okay, now see? That's better.
Now, Chief, I want you to just sit back and spectate. unless they team up on me, in which case, jump in.
I can't help but feel like I'm woefully unprepared for this.
And that's exactly what we prepared for.
This is my first real battle, and I've never seen anyone fight so fiercely. Gohan had always told me stories about the fights of the past, but those had a lot more screaming and posturing. But yeah. As soon as Gohan gave me upper hand,
damn, he's pissed today.
You think it's his time of the month?
It's funny because you're a chick.
Gohan! I can't believe you brought a kid to a battle. Super irresponsible.
She wasn't wrong. I'm not afraid of you. I can take care of you myself.
I, however, was.
Mm-hmm. Now what do you think?
You hit like a girl.
Duh. Oh,
you're not wrong.
Trunks!
I like Trunks. He's probably one of the best, most developed characters in the entire series.
Well, shit. Think he got away?
I don't know. We can't sense life energy.
Seriously, what was the point of not giving us that ability? Seems like an intentional design flaw, if you ask me.
Oh well. Scorched Earth.
Scorched Earth.
Not to sense self. Well, think about it. I mean, Dr. Joe wouldn't want them to, you know, run away, would they? Would he? Okay, cool.
Everything's in pain. Everything but my left arm. Ah, man. Too bad I'm not a Namekian. Really handy right about now. But I'll just settle on the next best thing and use the senzu beans.
Bean.
Singular. Well, that's disappointing.
Looking for male. Mid to late 30s, black spiky hair, not too tall.
Oh yeah, everyone's crazy in this.
To work out.
Hey, Mom?
What is it, Trunks? Oh my god!
What do you know about reattaching arms that I can't find?
Oh, sweetie. So, have you learned anything today?
The only good cyborg is a dead cyborg?
You really are your father's son.
Now stronger and more motivated than ever.
Wait a sec.
I was back to training as soon as Gohan was able again. Though I think
it's super sure is blue.
Sore.
Come on, Trunks.
But it is I got like green here.
Someone or something close to you.
Why don't you green?
Your arm. Just trust me. That really friggin' sucks.
And this Trunks has purple hair.
Alright, take five.
Unfortunately, I wouldn't transform in time. So, Gohan, do you usually hang out in Wastelands?
What do you mean? This is where I live.
Oh, it's nice.
I think you're really close, you know? You just need something to push you over the edge.
Well, you always tell me to use the pain of loss. But I've never really lost anyone.
For me, it's my greatest source of anger. I just think about losing Krillin or Mr. Piccolo.
Or your dad?
Yeah, sure. And then it just builds up inside until finally, it explodes. Yeah, like
I that.
We'll make the fort.
The cyborgs! Mr. Gohan, we have to go!
Does everybody find that annoying?
You stay here this time. We both know you're not ready.
Mr. Gohan, you only have one arm! What can you do with one arm?
He's homeless!
You know what? You're right. What can I do with only one arm?
Thank you, Mr. Gohan! I will not let you die!
There we go.
I can do that with one arm. Now, what can I do to the cyborgs with one arm?
Use the Makanko Sapo!
You never taught me that.
Use it!
You know what? I'm bored.
Well, we could find another city.
No, I mean, like, bored of this whole Great Destroyer shtick, you know? Destroying things, killing people. It's just boring.
Yeah, it's kind of lost its luster. After you wipe an entire genre of music off the face of the earth, what's left?
You know what I always wanted to do? Like, since before all this? Be a park ranger.
Mm-hmm. I want to range a park.
Hell yeah! Living outdoors, communicating with nature, shooting poachers. Yeah. I think I'm a do that.
You goddamn cheap son of a bitch!
He slapped your shit!
Okay, you know what? That's it. I'm killing every human. Every one. Then I'm gonna range the shit out of that park.
Neither of you are leaving here alive. I'm stronger than I was before.
Yeah, also lighter. Looks like you dropped some weight since last time. 5, 10 pounds? I don't know, how much does an arm weigh?
Gotta hand it to you, though. Pretty ballsy coming after us all asymmetrical like that. But four hands are better than one. Long story short,
true.
You're gonna die.
No, this isn't where my story ends.
This is where Gohan's story ends.
Well, this is it, Mr. Piccolo. But at least we still have Trunks. I trained him just like you wanted.
You know I'm not actually here, right?
Oh, crap baskets.
Down! Huh?
Aw, poor Trunks. First time I saw this, it was very, very, very heartbreaking. I think this is one of the great moments in, saddest moments in the Dragon Ball series. Yeah, I know it's not canon, but is this canon? I always saw this as canon. This is exactly what Dragon Ball Super is missing. Lots of emotion and destruction. This is what we need in Dragon Ball Super. We don't have anything like this in Super. Right, now if only you can do that twice. Well, one more time.
I got the rest of the supplies for the time machine. It's too bad Grandpa isn't here to help you build it.
Yeah, unfortunately, he's still off searching the cosmos for new Namek.
By God! Is that it? After all this? God damn it all!
So, until your grandpa returns, just me.
Hello! This is an emergency broadcast from Humanopolis! The cyborgs are attacking, and they are sparing no one!
Android cyborgs.
That's close to here.
Trunks, I know what you're thinking, but let me just finish the time machine.
We don't have time for that.
That's what the machine is for.
That's true.
I'm stronger now. I'm a Super Saiyan.
So was Gohan, and look how that turned out.
Oh, so now you're just replacing Dad with Gohan?
Trust me, I tried.
funny.
I'm going now.
Be safe.
And so, armed with the sword given to me by Tapion, which is a whole other story, I raced off to fight the cyborgs one last time.
We all wrapped up then?
Yep, looks like we're out of people to kill here.
Yeah.
Why don't you try me?
Wait, did you just ask? ask us to kill you?
No, as in fight me.
I'm sorry, do we know you?
Yes! You murdered my master!
Oh wait, hold on. I don't care.
Bitch slapped.
To this day, I'm still not sure why I did what I did.
Maybe it was grief.
Maybe it was puberty.
Probably not.
I just had something to prove. A young, half-blood Super Saiyan, armed with nothing but a sword in his guts. Unfortunately, half-human and half-Saiyan might just be analogous to half-brave and half-stupid.
Well, you got Vegeta and Goku, didn't you?
I did it!
Hey, doesn't he kind of remind you of you-know-who?
Now that you mention it, I do see the resemblance. But unlike good old Righty, he's still got both arms.
Yeah, but not for long.
Oh, crap.
And there you go.
You lost, little boy?
I wonder how old the androids are in this timeline.
Hey, Sunshine. Cough if you're still alive.
Good boy.
The question isn't why, kid. It's why not.
I mean, who's going to stop us?
Not those guys 17 years ago.
Not only one arm.
And certainly not you.
You? Mm. You? You evil fucking Jesus! Kick your neck!
This is hilarious.
Yeah. Although now it's kind of annoying. Now it's sad. And now it's annoying again.
Yeah, definitely sounds like a,
Wait a sec. This kid looked familiar to you, sis?
Yeah! He was at the amusement park with Stumpy!
Aw, who's a little survivor? You are, yes you are! Let's fix that, shall we?
Three years? I said no, he's not Goku.
Dibs, sis, get out of the- Did you just friggin' blast me?
You stepped in front of it! What is-
That's it! We're leaving!
Oh, come on!
I still have no idea how I survived.
Trunks, sweetie? You waking up?
Mom? Am I alive? How long was I out?
Well, I finished the time machine.
Oh. Is that long?
Yeah. Which means you got two options. You take another swing at the cyborgs, or you use the time machine to go save Goku.
I want to save Goku.
Trunks.
I want to save Goku.
Good boy. But yeah.
After recovering a few months, I was finally ready.
Hope.
Aw, my jacket looks so good on you. All the girls in the past are just going to love it.
Thanks, Mom.
So this is it. I can't believe I finally get to meet history's greatest hero.
Yeah, Goku might not be exactly how you think, so do temper your expectations.
And Dad! I finally get to meet Dad!
Oh shit, you do. Huh? I mean, just be yourself, sweetie, and everything will turn out okay.
Oh shit, you do.
Alright, Mom. Come
on. Next time you see me, this'll be a cyborg-free world.
Yep. Unless this actually operates on multiverse theory, in which case...
Can't hear you, Mom. Time machine!
Or Black. He's in here. Time Lord.
And multiverse theory it is. Shit.
Brilliant. Love that effect. Supreme Daleks. I miss the old shows. How cool would that be? To have the old Cybermen versus the new Cybermen. That would be freaking awesome to see. Yeah, I mean Doctor Who, I mean. Old versus new. Or alternate version meets alternate version. I think the old versions were more organized and seem more like more alien invader-y, if you know what I'm saying. Anyways, yeah, Dragon Ball Z.
can't believe they took my house.
We're going in for a food run. All that's left is the spam and the pork rinds.
We don't know this day would come, Ulo!
I have long since made peace with this. I'm just glad we're still alive.
All thanks to my submarine, the USS Medic! Speaking of which...
Oh, no.
I've been meaning to ask.
Knew it. I freaking knew it.
How does it feel riding my dick?
17 years. 17 years you've been holding on to that one.
You don't know the patience I have. Didn't answer my question either.
It's tight and damp.
Oh, that was funny. Light of Hope. Huh. Okay. Do I've seen a lot of comedy in most of Team Four Stars episodes, but I think this one had the most serious emotion in it. I mean, come on, who doesn't love Future Trunks? I'm actually glad he's back in Super. Fingers crossed. Super will give us a more emotional. Well, it's already given us a more emotional. You know what I'm trying to say. It's late at night. I'm tired. So yeah, that was pretty good. It was very well balanced. It was funny and it had its heart break moments. It was pretty good. Team Four Star really did a good job with this episode. Absolutely fantastic. Round of applause to them. It wasn't as funny as the last one, but I do like the serious emotional moments in this. So yeah, that's that. So yeah, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, follow me on Twitter, Tumblr, and Instagram, and I will see you guys next time. Cheerio!